My name is Keri-anne Payne and I'm an open water swimmer and I'm hoping to compete in London 2012 next year. To be the best in the world, you have to be relentless. You have to be so determined in what you want to do. You have to sacrifice the really important things you feel are important in your life. And you just have to remember that because it's not something that's going to happen overnight. I've been swimming since I was four. I mean, that's when I learned how to swim, but swimming as seriously as I have since 2002, so that's nearly 10 years of my life that has been swimming 50 weeks a year, training 10 sessions every single week. It's not something that's easy. You just have to get on with it. You have to do it. There's no point in doing something half. If you're going to do it, you know, you've got to do it. When I was younger, you know, I had no fear. I would swim next to girls that were, you know, like 6 foot, and I'd be like, oh yeah, you know, carry on, and I'd just get on with it, and I'd do what I needed to do. People always ask me the question, what would you be if you weren't a swimmer? And there was no doubt, I was always gonna be a swimmer. When I was a kid, I used to just sort of run up along the side of the pool. My brother would be swimming, so I'd, you know, run along with him just because I absolutely loved it and I wanted to be in the pool. And one day the swimming coach said, you know, why don't you start swimming, Keri-anne? You know, you can, next time you can come in. And I didn't hear the next time bit and I was like, okay. And I just literally jumped in the pool, fully clothed. I was just, you know, that was me, ready to go. And that's just how it's been since then. I always wanted to be, you know, the best I could and one step ahead. It is genuinely an amazing feeling winning any medal of any sort. You know, winning the World Championships was just out of this world, but you just got to make sure that you're staying that one step ahead all the time. So you know, enjoy the moment when it happens, but you know, it's back to training, 6 a.m. on Monday morning, driving yourself, defrosting the car, stuff like that, just sort of brings you right back down to earth. Even if you're the best in the world or, you know, the best in the country, you are always trying to better that. There's going to be days where you feel terrible and you really don't want to be there, but you just have to get on with it. That makes you a better swimmer, makes you a better athlete, you know, getting in the days that you don't want to get in. You have to be mentally just as strong as you are physically to do an open water swim. You've done 9,000 metres as hard as you can, and the last 1,000 metres is 10 times harder than the rest of that because you can see the finish, but it's one of those moments where it's like a cartoon where you look up and it just doesn't get any closer and you've been swimming for ages and you think, oh, why is that boy not getting any closer? Or the finish, why is it not getting any closer? I guess I'm very determined. You have to be a determined person to do kind of what I do every day, every morning. In the group, I do the most meters, so that can be quite difficult when they're all getting out early and you know you've got, you know, another 1,000 meters and another 10 minutes in the pool to do. You have to, you know, get there on the day with no regrets, knowing you've done absolutely everything you can. Standing there saying, yep, I've done absolutely everything possible, and no matter what the outcome, you have to be happy with it because you've done everything you can. At the end of the day, you can't control anybody else's performance. You can only control yourself. Yeah, to win an Olympic medal, I don't think life as an athlete gets much better than that. I think it's every athlete's dream to achieve, you know, the highest possible. So, you know, it's the challenge of it again, I guess, is what I just absolutely love about swimming and the competition and everything. So I just, you know, really look forward to getting in and just sort of getting on with it. It's going to be a strange day, I think, when I haven't got to get up at 6 in the morning. Yeah. Everybody's a swimmer somewhere if you've learned how to swim at some point. It just depends, I guess, on the level you're willing to sacrifice. For me, the most important thing about any kind of sport is making sure that you're enjoying it, because if you don't enjoy it, there really is no point in doing it.